Bring these babies into the world. They're gifts to us, and we need to have them start out the best way and the natural way, and breastfeeding is. It's the most precious gift you can give to your new baby. You can't replace it. It's something that you'll remember for a lifetime.
Then comes the lad with the hazel and the folding star.
The only thing that I guess kind of miss is because I can't sit and rock with her, you know, at nighttime, like in the middle of the night, you know, because she's the only one who can feed her. Well, when I go, when she wakes up, you know, I go after her and bring her over and tell her, you know, it's, she must be wanting to eat, you know.
When it's late at night or early in the morning, that's our time with my husband and I and Mary. It's such a good feeling to be so close. Well, usually when I'm nursing her, the two youngest ones come in, and Aaron loves to smell her head. He'll always smell the top of her head and around her ears and kind of nuzzle her. And the older boys, they like to carry her. They just love the clean smell that she has. I only wish I had breastfed my first two babies.
And how many of your children have you breastfed?
This is my, I have five children, and she's the fifth one, and I breastfed the last three. The first two I was, I don't know, young and didn't know and didn't have any advice. So the public health nurse and the CHR in my community were very supportive, and anytime I had any concerns or questions, they were there to help me out.
Human milk is the perfect food for human babies. Breastfed babies are healthy babies, and they have less digestive upsets, and they're less prone to developing things like colic, constipation, diarrhea. Breast milk contains antibodies, which are substances that keep your baby from developing infections and disease. In the beginning, babies need to be fed frequently, and on-demand feeding, which is whenever the baby is hungry, is the best way of feeding your baby. So with a newborn, you're looking at feeding every 1.5 to 3 hours. Breastfeeding is good for mom. Moms tend to lose weight and get their figures back very quickly. The baby's sucking causes the uterus to contract and to go back to its pre-pregnant state a lot faster than non-breastfeeding mothers. Extra fluids is very important, and a lot of women don't seem to like milk very much. You can get, it doesn't mean you have to drink milk, just as long as you get extra fluids. How will I know if my baby's getting enough milk? That's one of the most common concerns that mothers have. And because they can't see how much milk their baby's getting, they tend to forget that a nursing mother can produce all the milk that her baby needs.
When a mother is breastfeeding, it gives her and her baby that special bonding. And I think when the family sees this, there's just a really nice interaction among them.
Right now, I'd like to introduce Tracy Antone and her little daughter, Mary Elizabeth. And Tracy will give us a short demonstration on breastfeeding.
The best way to position the baby is tummy to tummy so that the baby can latch on properly and they feel more secure. The most important part is to get the baby on the nipple the right way, and that means putting the nipple between your fingers and make sure that the whole nipple is in her mouth, because if you don't, then you get the cracked and sore nipples, and it'll be a painful experience for you. And then when it's time to break the suction, usually I use my little finger here and just pop it in her mouth, and then the nipple will come away quite easily. And that prevents that. If you don't break the suction, then it's going to be a pulling action, and that'll really hurt. And of course, take away the joy of nursing her. She's so sleepy.
We talk about how your breasts are going to feel when you're in the hospital, and one of the feelings you're going to get is engorgement, where your breasts are full of milk and they're feeling tight and uncomfortable. What we suggest the mom do is to nurse on demand, and your breasts won't feel as full. We encourage a nice warm bath or a warm shower to massage the breasts and bring some of the milk out before you breastfeed, so your breasts aren't as tight when you're going to breastfeed your baby. I think even with our younger moms, whether they're first-time moms at 25 or whether they're first-time moms at 16, you can breastfeed. A mom should breastfeed for as long as she's comfortable. 13 months, it may be 2 years, it may be 3 years. This is the time for her to relax, enjoy her new baby, rest with the baby, and enjoy a good diet of healthy foods. Breastfeeding is not a good contraceptive. Initially, after birth, you should see your doctor 6 weeks after that, and you can discuss contraceptive devices with your doctor then, but you should be using an alternate method of birth control while you are breastfeeding. There's a lot of people you can get help from. It could be your doctor, it could be your community health representative or your community health nurse or somebody else who has had experience breastfeeding, or to call your Leleche League leader.
Try this. Who's this? Look in here.
Breastfeeding really is the better form of feeding, particularly native kids, because they suffer more health problems than non-native children. And breastfeeding has been shown to be more conducive to health. I mean, if a mother's really sincere on treating her child well, she can breastfeed for months and months and months, and the child will do extremely well. The advantages of breast milk is that it's sterile, it's clean, it's warm, it's affordable. It's beneficial in developing an immunity to the child to many illnesses. Its constituency of fat, protein, minerals is balanced, and the child really needs no more than that.
With my last three children, I was a gestational diabetic, and that means a commitment to good nutrition and watching your diet, being faithful in your diet, and make sure you're doing the best thing for your unborn child. And then once the baby is here, you know that you have that commitment that you're going to be breastfeeding her or him. Then it's, again, important to get all the nutrients and vitamins through good, healthy, balanced meals.
Gestational diabetes is development of diabetes during the pregnancy, the last half of the pregnancy. It has to be really checked for. There's no reason why a diabetic mother cannot breastfeed her child. So there's almost no reason for a mother not to breastfeed.
Our population having babies are a much younger population than the general population. And a lot of them are teens and are in that time of their life when they're dealing with sexuality and body image, and bearing the breast can be a hindrance, something that hinders them.
And this is what it reminds me of, the older times when I was a kid and I could see women, you know, they'd breastfeed the kids in the same room, the babies in the same room, and they'd be laughing and enjoying themselves. The atmosphere was nice and warm. It was a warm atmosphere, and you don't find that anymore. It seemed to be gone. I don't know how in the world a person could gain that back.
Well, at first, when she started with Aaron, you know, I was kind of shy about it, I guess. Like, it made me shy or embarrassed. But over the years, you know, I got used to it, and, you know, I don't see nothing wrong with it. You know, it's when it's time for her to eat, and you know, it's time, you know. And I don't think that it's anything to be embarrassed about. You know.
There's no reason why you can't sit at a table and nurse your child discreetly. And a lot of mothers just sit at the restaurant area and nurse their babies while sitting in a chair. It can be done so discreetly that passerbys don't even know that you're breastfeeding. And as long as you're wearing loose, comfortable clothes, then you can cart your baby anywhere and nurse anywhere you want.
I've been bringing Mary to work since she was about a week old. And she's been really a good baby. And I think it's important for other women to at least contact their employers and see if they can bring their children to work. Women can breastfeed discreetly by using, I always have my trusty receiving blanket with me at all times. And if I'm at a meeting, I always have my blanket and just having her covered up and myself covered up that no one even knows she's eating.
I don't know if it's reliable, but it's...
And with her here, she sleeps and she eats and I get just as much work done as if she was at home.
No introductions for the successful.
If a mother is ready to go back to work or go back to school, there's no reason to stop breastfeeding. There's a lot of ways to continue, and one of the ways is to express your own milk, and that way your caregiver for your child can give the baby the breast milk through a bottle. I did it myself. I went back to work when my children were both 4 months old, and I was really lucky that the daycare center was right close to my work. So I went over during break time and at lunch time and in the afternoon at coffee break time and nursed the babies. So it worked out perfectly, and there's no reason to stop breastfeeding when you do decide to go back to work or go to school or bring them with you.
I mean, it would be ideal if all mothers could breastfeed their children, particularly native children, because they need it so.
That's one of the, what I try to tell the kids is an old-time feeling, eh? It's, brings back a lot of memories, a lot of very nice memories. I remember when we first got married, my wife would breastfeed the first girl, eh? And it was nice to see that happening, eh? It'd give you, I suppose, a sense of responsibility and a sense of owning something that belonged to you, eh? Like a family of your own, eh?
There should be people to help them and support them in that decision. Yeah. In the long run, I guess it's their advantage if they do.
It's even hard to describe just looking into your baby's eyes while you're nursing, to have that that warmth and even just to nourish your baby knowing that you're nourishing your baby from your body just as you did while you were pregnant.
Oh, she's pretty.
Mary. I want to tell her all these experiences that I had when I was nursing her, how I used to sing to her and play with her fingers and toes and stroke her head when she was nursing, and how what a good feeling that is.